Well, in this weekend's Hometown Maine, we head to Norway. Now, the town was actually incorporated back in 1797 when Maine was still a part of Massachusetts. And at one time, Norway was home to dozens of factories, and for much of the 20th century, it was also known as the snowshoeing capital of the world. The town is also home to some great 19th century architecture, including one building where its past remains intact with its future. Let's head now to Norway for this weekend's Hometown Maine. Main Street is the heart of Norway. It's a busy road with a hometown feel where you're likely to find everything from cafes to hardware stores and even some arts and crafts. Now in 1894, a fire destroyed the south side of Norway. The Norway Opera House was also destroyed in that fire, but was rebuilt within a year and quickly became the center point of downtown Norway.
High school played basketball here, there were funerals held here, town meeting was held here, minstrel shows, all sorts of productions took place in this space up here.
In its heyday, people would line up outside these doors to see the likes of Rudy Valley on the second floor performance hall, where even today, people still have fond memories of some of those shows.
I'm told that there was a lady who used to come to all of the shows, and she had a particular seat, and it was hers.
Original chandelier.
But over time, the Opera House became privately owned and fell into disrepair, sitting empty on Main Street for years.
We had a serious collapse of some of the trusses at that end of the building that broke the sprinkler system and flooded the building.
In 2003, the building was listed as an endangered property. So the town went to court to claim it by eminent domain and was able to stabilize it through funding from a grant. Even though the performance hall remains a shell of its former self today, the restoration project for the entire building is now in the hands of the Norway Opera House Corporation.
It wasn't a walk in the park, for sure, but we have the ownership now. We've had a great success getting retail into the street level.
A $1.6 million project to renovate the first floor of the building came to fruition last year when four new businesses opened its doors.
And as soon as I saw these spaces, I sort of fell in love with the spaces and thought, what a great place to have a business.
Scott Burke opened this store called Fiber and Vine, where people come in, buy yarn, and actually knit right in the store.
We have knitting groups that come almost every afternoon.
The other half of the room over here is wine.
So we have wine. We have, again, wine. It's from all over the world.
The building now also houses an antique store, a business that creates a collection of museum-quality gems and minerals, and a company specializing in making fashionable handbags and luggage. While that part of the store is now open for business, the next phase is preserving and restoring its historic performance hall.
Well, we're looking to have multi-use space here. We will be able to bring it back as performance space, but it'll also be a place where we could have large conferences and weddings.
We really need $2 to $2.5 million to finish the job and do it right.
And as long as they have the support of the town and the funding,
we're going to finish and bring this old girl back to what she was.
There's something about your hometown that makes it unique, person, place, or thing. We, of course, want to hear from you. Email us at hometownme@wmtw.com, and maybe we'll feature your hometown in a future Hometown Maine. That is a fantastic building, and I hope the people of Norway get to see that beautiful building come to fruition here very soon.